There's my center. And let's see, I haven't even looked at this.
So you're not measuring any of these centers or anything, you're just drawing them?
Yeah, I just put them anywhere. Because for the most part, Becca, what I do is I usually draw outside of my print areas. Because I might have notes, I might have construction lines I feel like I leave on there. And then I'll come back later and do a copy. And I'll take these and put them into my print areas and then print them.
Yeah.
And I think you and me talked about
that. Yeah, we did.
All right, so I'm just picking a center point somewhere. So it looks like I've got that straight up circle is one major one. Yeah, so let me do the outside. So my center line is diameter 126. Diameter 126, there's my center line. That right where I hit this top one right here, that's going to allow me to draw this. So I'll do a circle here, and this guy has a size of 19. Then there's that other circle right on it that has a radius of 16. Right there. Now it looks like I've got to do two of them to get the line in between, don't I? So again, I'll just copy this thing right on top of itself. I'm going to use my pick box to get the top two. We'll do a rotate about the center, 360 divided by 5. Half calculator. 360, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 divided, 72 degrees. I'll rotate it 72. Now I can do this little one that's in between, and that's a tangent-tangent radius. From the tangent to that guy, tangent to that guy, and my radius is what? You trim that up. And let's see, these get trimmed too, right?
You did a tangent-tangent radius, right?
I did. Alrighty, so I think I'll just leave those three. I will have a little bit of trimming to do on the end, but I think I'll just leave that for now like such and array that around. Array, radius, curler. So there's that piece. Now, before I build the middle, let me just do the center lines here. So again, now that I've got this circle right here, you'll want to draw or even rotate this circle around also, unless you use the array. I'm going to use the array on it, but I can take this, rotate it so it's coming from the center out here, 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 and here, and then build them all individually if I wish. Again, here's that 8th and 16th. So I'm going to come in here and do a circle. It's got a 1.6. Do an offset of 1.6. That's not a bad enough offset, 1.6. There we go. I'm going to trim all four of these when I'm doing the center mark for a circle. I'm then going to move these two from here to, let's see. Yeah, I'll just move them here right now. to get in the center of this point right here. So I'm going to do a line right here, submit between two points. And I'll extend that up. That should give me that center point. Let's move that from there to there. Now I'll trim it. Let's see, I need that piece also. So let me move these again. And all I need here is this piece. Okay. I'm going to take that off. And I think we can delete this whole thing. Sweet. Yeah, that's what I want to array right there. Oh, the other thing is I want this outside one to go with it, as well as the inside. I'll come back and fix that later. So I'm going to do my offset of 3.2. About an eighth inch path, there and there. Okay, so we'll trim that off, and now we should be good. Delete those back out, and looking like such. Now let's go ahead and do a polar array on that. That is my center. No, I got it off these arcs right here. I can use that. There's my center point. Maybe five of these. Those are right. Yeah, that should produce those. Yeah. Let me go ahead and draw the middle of this thing now. So these are 12.3. We've got to have a couple diameters. Looks like one's at 64. Circle with a diameter of 64. Another one that has a diameter of 50. So there they are. And I'm offsetting 12.3, huh? Okay. So offset 6.15. That way and that way. That gets trimmed, that, that. And let's see, I think this is gone also.
Yeah.
The outsides are gone. Okay. And how many of these are there? One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Is there eight of those?
Mm-hmm.
Let's do a polar array on just this piece.